Hello everyone, welcome back to a new video of Microsoft Excel short VBA code series that is running into my channel. Friends, in this series we are going to learn some interesting and short and unique codes that we can use into our codes to make that code easier and also time saver. So in my previous videos we have discussed some of that codes that I have already showed you in my channel, and today in this video we are going to learn about that code with which we can copy active worksheet into a new workbook. So before getting into it, make sure to check the description box. There you will find the link of downloading this workbook, where you will find all of that codes in a single place. I am using the single piece of worksheet so that you can find it in a single place. And make sure to subscribe this channel and also press the bell icon to get all notifications from my channel. So without wasting any time, let's get into it. So at first we have to click on options and enable this content to actually use the previously recorded macros into this worksheet. So friends, then we have to go to the developer tab, then click on Visual Basic, or you can directly click on Alt F11 key to get into the Visual Basic editor. So here in sheet 2 we are going to insert a new module. I have showed previously 4 modules till now. Now I am going to insert a new module here. So here today we are going to talk about module 5. So what we are going to do, we are going to copy active worksheet into a new workbook. Whole new workbook will be inserted whenever we run that code. So let's begin that code. At first you have to use the SUB, that means the sub procedure, and have to name that sub procedure. To make it simple and clearly understandable, I am going to name it as copy worksheet to new workbook. Let me write it. After writing the name of that sub procedure, open bracket, then close bracket and hit enter. Look at here your sub procedure name has been now changed, that is copy worksheet into the new workbook, and in sub has been entered automatically. So at first we have to type this workbook, then full stop. Here you have to select active sheet from the drop down menu. Highlight that option into that drop down menu and press tab button from your keyboard. It will be automatically filled in your code. After that, put again a dot, then type copy, copy, put a space and put a underscore here. Make sure to put a space here after writing copy. Then here you have to hit enter. Now type before, then colon, give a equation symbol. Here type as workbooks dot add, select add, that means add, from the drop down menu. Here after highlighting it, hit on tab button from your keyboard. Again put a dot. Then here you have to select worksheets. Worksheets. Select that, then open the bracket. Here you have to type number 1, that will determine your worksheet number into that new copy. Then close the bracket and hit enter. Now your code has been completed, and whenever you run that code, look at here what happens. I am going to run this. Before running it, save it by pressing Ctrl S, and make sure whenever you save it, make sure to save that file as macro enabled workbook from the save as type option. And save it. I'm gonna cancel it because it has been already saved by pressing Ctrl S. Now look at here, I am running the code by going through the developer tab, then macros, then select that VBA code we have already edited, or you can directly run that code from this Visual Basic editor by clicking through this green play button that is run sub or user form. or by pressing the F5 button from your keyboard, or by going through the run then run sub or user form. So I am going to run that code directly from developer tab, then going through the macro, select that newly edited VBA code, then click on run. Look at here, if you hover over the Excel application, you will find two applications, that is, one is Microsoft Excel and one is Visual Basic Editor, right? And when we run that code, look at here, it has been run successfully. Now what happened, sheet 3 has been inserted here and a new workbook has been automatically inserted. Look at here, here now we have three applications. One is practice sheet, which was our main sheet, and one has been newly entered. If we cross this and don't save it, look at here, I am running the code again. I am typing now something here. I have now typed something in sheet 3. We have typed this, and whenever we run that code by macros, then copy worksheet into new workbook and click on run. Look at here, it has been successfully copied and sheet 3 has been inserted here by going through the number we have entered. So this code actually works successfully. This code may be very important to you or anyone whenever you have to copy in a new workbook and you have a lots of data into your database. So that's all for today, friends. Hopefully you like this video. I'll come back soon with another interesting video and short VBA codes soon. Till then, keep learning, keep supporting this channel and keep practicing by downloading the workbook, and please share this video with your friends who wants to learn Microsoft Excel VBA from the beginning level.